spring, and No Name was one of the first ones to do it here in the North American LCS in the summer split. So they'll stop that right there.
Yeah. So far, though, no top lane bans. There's a lot of very strong top laners available right now. Yep. Gragas and Nidalee are probably the two strongest as far as lane bullies are concerned right now. And Gragas, definitely one of Dyrus' favorites. But Nidalee as well, stepping into the scene. Quash showed that he could handle her fairly well, though. So if you get enough practice in, then maybe she's not all she's hyped up to be.
That's going to ban out this game. A lot of the jungle has been left to the wayside in focus of bans today. Nunu does, as we said, find out the first one. But Kog'Maw is going to be the last ban with more mid and that one top focused in Italy. Does he lock in the Gragas now?
They ban out Nunu, but they leave up Lee Sin and Lee. So those will probably be our two junglers in this game. And they don't have to early pick one of those junglers since both of them are up.
I could say they have to take Tristana if they're going to leave it up. That's their takeaway from Vasili. And then the Kog'Maw's banned, so he's forced to go on to something else now. Very good play, at least, there. I don't think Vasili would be thrown off too much, though. LMQ's champion pool is quite big in every lane.
Yeah, Twitch still up. Caitlyn still up.
Right.
Definitely some options that Vasili is still comfortable with. Taking up the lane partner, though, with Braum. And yeah, Gragas is
good,
a really big takeaway from Dyrus. As we said, Dyrus has really fallen in love with that champion up in the top lane.
Actually hasn't reverted much to Lulu this season either. He only has two Lulu games coming out in that top lane. Ones that have been quite well. One win, one loss.
Yeah, it's kind of funny how the top lane kind of turned into champions that are rejected mid laners. Like, Ryze got kicked up there, Kayle got kicked up there, Lulu, Gragas. All these people that can't really hack it anymore in mid lane. Nidalee's now up there all the time.
Soon Xerath, man.
Hey, Soaz played Ziggs up there, so.
Yep. Some Kassadins, some Gragas's.
There's your Lulu, though.
Let's see where it goes. I'm not so sure we saw a mid lane Tristana already, so. No, Wild Turtle probably.
Yeah, that is, I'm pretty sure that's a specific Voivoi strategy there. Not a lot of the other North American mids, at least, have been practicing the Tristana mid. Definitely a Voivoi special.
Okay, amazing. Pulling out the Rango Knife Cat. It looks like they're going to put together a composition that seems like it would kind of zero you out, but also want to keep the fight going for a while.
Yeah, so the thing is, if you're picking Rengar over Lee Sin and Elise here, then you really need to make something happen with those ultimates.
Whoa.
The Ezreal. Now,
like
Ezreal's an interesting AD carry that's been blind picked over in Korea above all other options in some of the games. And Vasili has always been a guy who really likes that champion as well, so opting for that instead of the Twitch or Caitlyn this time around. Ezreal's a very tricky champion. Depends all on if you hit those skill shots in lane phase. If you miss a couple in a row, then you can easily just lose out that entire lane.
That whole team is skill shot dependent. LMQ is bringing out the skills on this one. We'll see if they can get everything to hit. They are a very mechanically enhanced team. Still, they go with the Xiaowei Xiao Twisted Fate. Looking back, he has.
I'm wondering about that mid lane because anytime you're facing a Rengar jungle, your mid lane has to be real careful. You know, TF is definitely a prime target for Rengar as soon as he does hit that level 6. And Xerath can easily follow up on any Rengar gank without giving away the Rengar gank because the range on Xerath is so long. Bjergsen doesn't have to play differently at all.
Right.
Doesn't have to give anything away. And all of a sudden, you're getting rooted by Amazing as soon as he jumps in with a 5 Ferocity Bola Strike.
Also, something that can stick on an Ezreal, which works. You are going to have a little bit of that kite, but if, like you said, you can hit those Bola Strikes, you're going to be back on your target in a matter of no time. So as we lock in these ones, we do see Twisted Fate was picked by Xiaowei Xiao, I believe it was in Week 7 against CounterLogic Gaming. They did get a win there, so it has been attested, Twisted Fate. See if you can keep making the plays. Before the game gets underway, let's see how you have been voting over at LOLESports.com. And you voted 65%. That it's going to be Team Solo Mid leading LMQ coming into this match.
Yeah, and keep on tweeting your votes to at LOO Esports. Use the hashtag either TSMWin or LMQWin. This game, after seeing the Champions League, I think a lot is actually going to rely on Xiaowei Shao, that TF. Mm-hmm. If Xiaowei Shao can have a good early game and a good start, get LMQ off aggressive, and start teleporting around the map, then he can actually increase the chances of the side lane, exert his will on the other side of the map. But if he gets targeted early by TSM, then this LMQ team could very easily collapse.
We'll have to watch what Bjergsen can do in the mid lane. He's been kind of making some social media tweets and, you know, these champions are back, these are not. We haven't seen him yet, but maybe that's when TSM really needs to pull out all the hard straws and make sure they get the win that they want. Coming up towards the end of the season here, these are going to be big ones. We see LMQ trying to shoot for first place. Now that is actually happening because CounterLogic Gaming lost earlier today versus Evil Geniuses. So LMQ is really looking to get a top spot within the North American LCS. A lot of teams, as they came into the season, said LMQ would, in the end, be a middle-of-the-pack team, and they're trying to prove that.
Yeah, especially with, you know, CLG losing earlier today. It is LMQ's time to shine. Can they take it?
Welcome to Summoner's Rift.
Cruising around. The Nami pick on Glebe. Get some Surfle. Safeness for Wild Turtle. And we're actually going to get a quick listen-in with how Glebe felt about Champion Select. Let's take it here.
We know this comp. We got our picks. Now we just got to play the game.
Last time TSM said they knew the comp and they got their picks was against CLG and they lost the game. See if they can actually execute this time around with LMQ. This LMQ team is a very mobile LMQ squad here.
Yeah.
Almost everybody having their own dashes built in. And then Xiaowei Shao with the very popular Ghost Flash now. It's funny how it was kind of pioneered by Dade in Korea a long time ago. The only guy was doing it for a long time. Now everybody's hopped on the
train. It's Taster's choice in the mid lane, man. You got to take it.
Well, with the arms race that's going on in the mid lane with everybody wanting more wave clear and more range, who can bring out the bigger guns, it's definitely turned more towards mobility.
Still waiting for the Lux in North America, man.
Yeah.
Still waiting. It's getting love everywhere else.
LPL and GPL. Get a little taste.
Every time someone plays it, though, they're like, that guy's crazy, or he was amazing to hit all those skill shots, because it is. It's very hard to hit all of them, but it's becoming a skill shot game. It's eventually going to happen.
Yeah, especially with Ziggs and Xerath, though. Might be a while till we see Lux come up.
I know. Wishful thinking. We start off the game here just a mere 2 minutes in. Red buff being stolen up, so standard starts by both junglers. We'll see how this lane in the mid goes. Xiaowei Shao, does he keep his farm up? And does he keep Bjergsen down?
A couple of defensive wards here early on from TSM as well. Lee Sin can get the advantage on Rengar if he finds him in the jungle. No funny business, though. We do get the standard lanes we expected, and it is going to be about who can make that first early move. Already, yep. Dyrus is shoving up very quickly with Lulu to get the wave advantage on Ackerman, and we'll see if No Name would make his way all the way back up there. Because he started red, which is further away from his duo lane, a little bit slower jungle, and it means he will end his route further away from that top lane.
Yep. Like you said, I like what TSM's doing, Kobe. Pushing all the lanes in right now and trying to get a nice little bit of a lead, so No Name has a lot more things to think about. Just
yeah.
Lane here.
It's always a good idea to coordinate your strategy among all your lanes because
right.
Tristana actually has no option but to push unless you decide not to level up your explosive shot, which would mean you have
Lower
no early
rats.
Trading. So Tristana, obviously, always going to push up. Easy target for many junglers. No Name goes around the back. No ward here. And this is the first successful gank already
right.
able to get in here.
It's all about the Glebe bubble. Can he hit it? Doesn't throw it out just yet. Goes for the sustain first. They do hit the rest of what they want. Two flashes blown in the bottom lane. The commotion has started. So Xiaowei Shao with an immediate look on that Bolo. Dodges two out.
Both
what a
summoners,
fast
though.
Flash. Yeah,
man.
Very quick.
Both junglers at the first ganks get two summoners each. Well played by both.
From both sides.
Targeting different lanes, though. As we said, as TSM are going to look at this mid lane. They don't want to let TF get out of control. Meanwhile, Tristana is such a beast late game. LMQ wanted to prey on her obvious early pushing.
Right.
And both of them are rewarded. We'll see if they return to the lanes, though, or decide to actually go for counter ganks.
It would always be good to get Bjergsen going on. Xerath, first time here, bringing out in the LCS would not hurt to get a bit of a lead on a champion the first time you're bringing it out in this high priority or high skilled play.
Yeah, and look at what this does to the lane. Xiao Xiao has to play so ridiculously safe now, having burned both summoners.
Yeah.
Amazing with the early return to lane. What a good call by Xiao Xiao to realize there's no option for him. He cannot extend up into this lane without wards, so he goes back immediately to buy some more vision for himself. No Name also going to help him out, buy some extra vision as well.
That little push by Amazing as well. They didn't see that Xiao Wei Xiao was still there and perfectly pushed the lane in. He does miss a good amount of CS. So everything, even the smallest things, being coordinated nicely by Team Solo Mid. Gold is still even. Xiao Wei Xiao reapproaches the lane 33 to 24. We'll see if he can get himself back into a position to shut down Bjergsen, who, like we said, had a chance to buy that chalice now. Coming back to lane. Turtle, a little too close. He's getting shots on a very pushed wave. You can see the explosive shot's going to push it even more for him, so it's getting hard here.
A similar thing happened to this bottom lane as what went on in mid here. Mm-hmm. You know, Tristana loves to push early, especially against the Braum lane, but it's so dangerous for them now because Lee Sin and Braum are such a great tag team for lane ganks because they can both dash to allied units, and they can easily just, even if you ward up perfectly, Lee Sin can come through lane and punish you. So Glebe specifically has to play further back. Turtle at least does have his rocket jump to rely on.
And the scrying orb coming
out
of Bjergsen. That was a very close lockdown. The Bolo after that as well. No Name comes in for a bit of help, and he is going to be able to thwart the attack. Xiao Wei Xiao playing very aggressive for a zero summoner's play, but they knew they had some control there.
Yeah, and some extra harass on the exit there. Now, we're about to see Bjergsen hit level 6, and Xiao Wei Xiao is dangerously low. Xerath is definitely capable of finishing off that
Zero out instantly.
Who has no summoner spells. Let's see if Bjergsen can rush this level 6.
No Name.
There it is, but Xiao Wei Xiao immediately backs off to his turret.
He has the mana for it, too.
He's going to have to land more harass before to set this up, though.
I really like the way No Name's been playing, always staying in the mid lane. He'll probably do it until these summoners are up for Xiao Wei Xiao, and he's also just getting in the face of Amazing to make sure he can't gank mid lane.
The thing is, with all these ganks mid lane, Amazing is delaying his level 6. He's only level 4 here at 6:45, so it's going to be a while before he does get his level 6. Needs that extra comeback experience from farming the jungle. Probably just going to wait until his buff comes back up. You get a lot of bonus experience being that low level and killing the buff monsters.
We saw this previously when Kez was on Elise and Dominate was on Rengar. Kez didn't really put too much pressure onto that Dominate Rengar, but now that we see No Name is, we're not seeing the same early game
here
results.
We go.
Can you get it? Oh, he goes down the red card. It's going to be enough, though. It's going to be enough.
So even though he pulls the red, it's plenty because
said you're
of
out of the
early
game.
Gank by Nogan. Yeah.
Wee! Save. Catches that one on the backside. He'll clean up and get back into the fight. Amazing. Now hitting 6.
Is.
Now going to be able to create some opportunities, and he might even go double turrets here onto Xiao Wei Xiao, but they don't have knowledge of where No Name is. So.
They should definitely be calling that Xiao Wei Xiao just uses Ghost down bottom, too, so... He's a prime target here for Amazing, but he knows it, and they have a ward on the red side jungle. Xiao Xiao, Xiao Amazing, get into this position. So you will not see him get away from his turret right now. Amazing out of luck.
It's like Vasily has had enough of farming in lane, and they're going to go ahead back and get some purchases in. 73 CS to 49 CS in that lane. It's okay to be behind a bit with Tristana, but that's a good amount.
Uh-oh. Yeah, it was about the lane, the early lane ganks for the junglers. Like we thought, you can see the same discrepancy mid lane as far as CS is concerned.
Right.
The jungler impact on both of these lanes, you can really see the choices by both teams and which area they want to focus. Thing is, for TSM, even though they focused mid, Xiao Xiao still got off a successful first TF ultimate.
Very good plays and always making them count when they get the chance. LMQ rarely goes into a situation where you'll see them completely come out on the wrong end. Pushing up still from Bjergsen here. He tries to get the wave continuously cleared into the turret to keep eyes on Xiao Wei Xiao. No more cheeky Destiny plays. Setting up for a bit of dragon control here. We'll see if LMQ can get this with a ward being just in the back of Dragon Pit.
Yeah,
they got it. No
pressure. What happened is TSM stuck around to shove that last lane. preying on the bottom lane's back timers. Very good job by LMQ. That's the communication that we're talking about really early in the day, about communicating what time your lane opponents are going to want to return to base. You can keep track very easily just of the gold and estimate when your opponent is going to want to go buy their next item. Tristana goes back, having not purchased at all in the game, and they get the dragon for it.
Not a lot of commotion is coming out of the top lane just yet. Ackerman's definitely been able to provide a very scary Gragas play, providing a tank utility for the team in the late game, and we know Dyrus to play quite a good Lulu in his utility, so much to see from them as this game goes on. 82-75 in that lane. Ackerman just off being able to complete his Rod of Ages for now. Dyrus has been happy to keep farming up.
Yeah,
he says it's time to buy, Dyrus.
Top lane back to their own devices because there's so much focus mid for TSM and bottom for LMQ. And again, you know, the bonus of focusing bottom lane is that you get that dragon control. Translates into a nice global gold lead for LMQ.
Great harass in the top lane. Ackerman on the minimap keeping Dyrus from backing there, being a little nuisance. We'll see if he or Amazing can get any movement out of this. Go ahead, place a deeper ward on Wraith. They'll have some good control here of the map as TSM trying to make some moves after knowing they lost that dragon. They might want a little bit of something.
All right, let's see what he can do here. Ultimate not used yet for Amazing. And Ackerman is going super aggressive.
Oh, what a perfect time to get him using his ultimate. Dyrus is going to sit there and say, oh no, I can't fight this. But yes, I can. Here comes Amazing on the back side. And they bait in an Ackerman.
So with Dragon already gone, that's the open time to go for those top lane ganks.
Yeah.
We'll see what they can do with that on the top lane pressure, though.
Fast feet, Xiao Wei Xiao, dodging out Bjergsen's skill shots on that one. They're able to turn this around and trade back a bit of damage as Moore throws up the shield. Now settling into mid lane, Amazing's going to be able to push top. TSM looks to get mid, and LMQ adapts to the strategy.
What a roam mid from the bottom lane of TSM. The turret's not down, there's no... The wave was just shoved up, so they took the opportunity to go mid, and it's a good thing they did, because Bjergsen going aggressive at the same time. LMQ, we're looking to make him pay for it. Lane swap here called for by TSM. Because we are getting to that mid game where Tristana really wants to farm to a completed Infinity Edge for her next item, switching up Turtle to get a little bit easier of a farm lane here. This Ezreal, one of the things that he still has is a great build path. Trinity Force into Blade of the Rune King is very popular and gives you a lot of skirmish ability. And with the focus from jungler down bottom, it's very easy for Ezreal to capitalize on any gank, whether it be from Lee Sin or TF.
Ooh.
Another red card.
Speedy Whimsy. Xiao Wei Xiao, another Destiny down to the bottom lane. That one wasn't dangerous, but it also didn't work. So we're going to get a push on the lane. We'll be waiting a little bit of time before LMQ really tries to make another push.
And Vasili shoving out this bottom lane, they may be looking to answer the swap here from TSM. LMQ probably want to counter that swap. They've already sent support up top.
Ooh,
not able to pull an ulti.
Nope, trying to reel in that fight.
That ult. They still have so many resources up here, though.
Amazing on full stacks, tries to get in. Will he have to blow flash here? The Dragon's Rage into the Sonic Wave.
Oh,
resonating strike
finish.
Nobody follows up for Amazing. The team's going down, but they take down Braum as well. Two for one so far in the fight. Dyrus teleports right into the middle of the fight. He's probably regretting that decision right now. A double kill for Xiao Wei Xiao. Wild Turtle is forced to put on the full shell and head out.
That was a good plan from TSM and very bad execution. TSM could have had the easy numbers advantage because Ezreal is down bottom with Lulu and Lulu's got teleport, but nobody comes at the same time here. Turtle is in the lane still. Gragas makes the early roam mid, and because Amazing starts this off without the rest of his team, he basically started off 2-1. He's out of the fight so early. Even though Bjergsen goes deep to try and answer the kill, he's out of position, and TSM all trickle in one by one. Just poor communication and execution from TSM there in a situation that could easily have gone in their favor with a 5-4. They just were not grouped up all at the same time to make that play happen.
definitely pushing themselves into a dangerous situation to get back. Just that dragon, very, very on the edge of their seat. Cream gained back a little, and it seems like they've fallen off.
Yeah, plus they use their teleport to try and salvage that play, and it's 50 seconds until this dragon comes up. It won't be available. Now TSM are the ones at the disadvantage. If a four versus four fight breaks out around dragon, Ackerman will join, and Dyrus won't be able to. So that action from TSM will have later repercussions as soon as this dragon does spawn.
Dyrus trying to keep Ackerman in his vision. He can still polymorph the teleport out of that and make the fight a little bit more in favor of Team Solo Mid here. But they don't have all the poke we actually saw coming out of the first composition of the day. Having more Nidalee, having a little bit more poke even from the bottom lane, and Morgana. With this Xerath, TSM can't put the same amount of pressure down onto an objective, so it seems like they're trying to find out if LMQ will make a mistake anytime soon. Mid lane is a possibility. You just saw the health on that turret very, very low. So maybe Team Solo Mid can kind of dance out that dragon fight and then pressure mid as LMQ rotates to the dragon.
I think that TSM might end up having to give up the dragon because not only do LMQ have a teleport, but they also have several key items here. Trinity Force on Ezreal is really big for them. And also, Ackerman is shoving in up top. So even if he leaves lane, Dyrus won't be able to answer with that top turret.
Dragon's alive. You see most of TSM keeping those members in mid lane as No Name starts to get a lockdown on it.
Yeah,
if Xiao Wei Xiao can hold this mid turret, this will be huge for LMQ and they can still get the dragon.
It's gonna work on it. So Ackerman's gonna shove Dyrus into his turret as quickly as he can. And then get away from Dyrus. If he wanted to join, he would have to still get out of range of Dyrus. Amazing heads up top, so TSM make the call. They're giving it up. 100% giving it up. They do not want to fight it.
No pressure on the mid lane either. TSM is spread thin across the map, and they get nothing out of that dragon. Mid lane being a definite possibility as well.
Yeah, they made the call for Amazing to head up top, but he's walking right through a ward, so TSM literally cannot get anything out of that. And again, this is because of the early move that TSM made on this red side jungle. Ends up making them lose out on a dragon.
Uh-oh, you can see the priority. Oh, the gold card comes out this time. Third time's a charm. You're gonna be locking this one down. He says, where are you going? Stay and have a drink. Dyrus goes down, 30 seconds on the clock.
LMQ are just dismantling TSM, making them pay for that mistake. Whenever you're facing a TF team, especially, if you make one small mistake, with your globals, then it snowballs very quickly.
Xiao Wei Xiao knows what he's facing. That's his main right there in Tristana. And he's going to be able to play against it very accordingly. 174 to 130, we saw that CS advantage coming, as we said, from the jungle pressure in the early game. And Vasili's been able to hold it very nicely. Heading to the mid lane, we can see priority on the boot selection. Alacrity for Xiao Wei Xiao for playmaking. As little playmaking with his speed on the cards, but still there's playmaking in the distortion as well from Bjergsen.
Yeah, the thing is, I would you would expect a distortion on Xiao Xiao too,
right,
because he
right.
also has the Flash Ghost, but he just wants permanent move speed.
Yep, get those cards locked in.
Not when he's blowing as summoners. Very interesting choice. Especially if you're running Flash Ghost. The value of a distortion enchantment just seems like it's so high.
If it was for one person, it'd be Dyrus. I mean, they're bringing their teleports to Dyrus on the off chance that he's made it out on Whimsy every time. You know, Xiao Wei Xiao is able to connect it. But that's a big buy for one dude. 5-2 here, 18 minutes on the clock. We're just going to get some ward wars.
Looks like they're jumping on Dyrus here, and they burn his flash for just the ultimate.
Yeah.
Now, the thing about the Alacrity upgrade for Xiao Wei Xiao, the only bonus it has over distortion is that in lane, it makes it easier for him to dodge Xerath Rask.
Yeah.
So that is actually really important for him. And I'm pretty sure the only reason he is doing it this game is because they're facing the Xerath and he wants to dodge those long range skill shots.
We did actually see him using Ghost earlier in that situation to get out. So he'll be saving a Ghost. He'll be a lot more happy. You're right. Slow pushes on the top. Then they finally get it. 2-2 in turrets on the map. Bjergsen, they're finally looking to set up a little bit of this poke, and he can put out the damage.
Yeah, half life right there.
No No Name looking to get in from the side and make some moves. You can see this actually wants to be a very big move for Team Solo Mid. Bjergsen with the Brilliance Elixir in his inventory to get that extra damage out. These guys are putting some extra money into the stat.
Whoa, they need to teleport early from Darius if they're going to get caught here. LMQ does not pull the trigger, though. Guess it was a defensive TF ultimate to save their blue buff. Good call by TSM, leaving Darius up top. They don't panic teleport down there, and they at least get a minion wave into the turret.
Darius getting a really nice ward and a great minion wave in the top side to keep pushing, but he's starting to rotate over. Is he going to really try to steal out Red? They can still see Red is trying to run about. Amazing.
Ooh.
Taken out, nicely done by No Name to steal it
back.
Wait, the rest of LMQ has kind of filtered in on the backside, and they didn't realize TSM was ready for a fight. TSM is going very low. The area of effect damage coming in huge from Ackerman, and they're going to continue this one on the flash body slam into Glebe. They're serving up sushi tonight with a double kill from Braum. Continuing now, Wild Turtle,
he's
no jump,
done.
No reset. The artillery. Xiaowei's forced to turn tail there, turns on the ghost, and he says that was close.
Bjergsen laying down the cover fire there for Turtle, scares off Xiaowei, and they don't chase down the extra kill, which was a very real possibility using those alacrity boots. So here, even though they catch Vasili, and Bjergsen plus Amazing, crazy burst onto Vasili to take him out of the fight. They used everything at that point. Everybody's on the run now. This was actually a very high-value red card from Xiaowei. He wanted the AoE damage and the AoE slow to go along with his wild cards. So much area of effect damage from the LMQ to answer just the one kill that TSM caught. Pretty big play, and it does increase the global gold lead for LMQ.
LMQ making a real good fight for three in a row versus Team Solo Mid here in the summer split. TSM looking to right now stop that losing streak against LMQ, and they can make it even if they can grab this one here with two more games left in the season versus these guys.
TSM trying to hold on, and you can see how little information they have. The pings from TSM on Dragon a minute early because they don't know what time it's coming up. They want to get down some vision inside that pit. One of the easiest ways on this patch to snowball games from an early lead is just control every single dragon. And LMQ can easily do that, so TSM going to try and get back some more information for the team to give them hopes of countering. So much vision control from LMQ.
Yeah.
If you try and go anywhere near that dragon pit, you're going through LMQ vision.
Security system.
And they can easily pick you off. They've got such a mobile team and a TF to start it off who's already rushed his Zhonya's.
They're going to have a second one, too, coming out on Ackerman. So even more plays to be made when you're trying to focus down the wrong guy, which at the time will be right.
Oh,
but LMQ is ready to strategize around whatever you think you have planned. Dragon's going again, Kobe. 7,000 gold, the 8,000 as they start this.
TSM in a very, very scary spot here. They just go to try and steal it.
No Name gets it. Amazing is going to be the first one in the fight. Even if he throws his ultimate on, he's going down immediately. That's the ultimate of Destiny coming out. Does he go in the middle of the fight? No, he goes towards the backside. Dyrus gets locked down. The late wild growth only stops LMQ for so long, and we can't even see Bjergsen on the screen. All of TSM has already left the fight.
That's
trying to fight from the outside.
That's why that fight is so dangerous to go look at. Not only do LMQ control all that vision, but if you even get near LMQ, they will hard engage on you. All the champions are so mobile, and they have the early Zhonya's TF. There's no way you're getting away from it. Going to contest a dragon snowballs that one fight to not only a dragon, but a Baron, which is ridiculously hard to come back from. Ginormous mid-game lead here from LMQ.
That is huge. Junglers don't even have second items completed, and we're looking at Barons here 23 minutes into the game. Check this fight out one more time.
Yeah, Amazing goes in for the steal, but he literally doesn't get a single spell. He got one spell off before he died, trying to get his heal, and it didn't matter at all. And
Braum
then
blocked.
You can see, they just cut everybody off. They've got Ackerman, very mobile Gragas with teleport as well. Xiaowei Xiao, there's no way you're getting away from him.
I was wondering why Glebe held that tidal wave so long, and then I felt his pain when I watched Moore block it with a shield.
Yeah, exactly. That's why people get so frustrated in the Nami versus Braum matchup, and that's why pretty much everybody, if you see the Braum first, go with the Morgana
pick. It's those intense moments in a fight when you know exactly what your job is, but you're waiting for the other guy to make that one move. Held off for a long enough time, and they were able to take down Amazing. The fight in LMQ's favor, now leading to them pushing down mid lane. Looking at a 12,000 gold lead right now, Kobe. That's very hard to stop, especially when you're the one dictating all the moves. TSM is forced to adapt to everything now. It's a good thing their side lanes are pushed because they can deal with this in mid, but I don't think they're going to be able to deal with it for very long.
No, they have no chance of having that turret. Not only is the Trinity Force Bork build on Ezreal extremely good for skirmishes and spread out teams like this, but it's also great at taking down turrets pretty early on.
Right.
In those Trinity Force procs.
You get attack speed, you give attack speed.
There's such a huge spike here in skirmish power for Vasili. And he's almost finished his last Whisper on top of it, even though not much armor on the board for TSM. It's a preemptive last Whisper, I guess.
I like the rush by Amazing on the Locket, helping with a bit of the burst they find and all this. It's really wild AoE that they're trying to dodge. Once the cards go out, they have a barrel, a sonic wave, all these skill shots. Oh, just tucked into the wall. Dyrus saves himself with the outside of his base.
That was very good for TSM. He almost negated that entire ult with just the shield on himself.
See, the sustain coming in ever so slowly on the side of Team Solo mid, but it hasn't seemed to help too much. You can see Vasili sustaining just as well with the Blade of the Rune King on his side. He was taken down to half health just now, but
this is
able to keep him safe.
This is really the test for TSM, though, because LMQ, they're running such a heavy mid-game power spike team. If TSM somehow hold out in this last ring of inhibitor turrets, then they will have a chance later if they can turtle it out long enough and defend the Alamo here. But man, is it, the odds are really not in their favor.
Well, here we go. Xiaowei Xiao definitely getting some calls from No Name, captain of the team, to say, we still have this, Baron's down, map is objective free, let's start to spread Team Solo mid thin. Xiaowei Xiao now in the split push towards mid while Baron still ticking on LMQ. They're gonna force themselves into base.
They make the swing down the bottom, even calling Xiao Xiao over.
Yeah.
TF ultimate is available, by the way. He could stay mid.
Yep.
And just TF ultimate as soon as there's a hard engage at this turret. Every time, though, TSM's actually sent two members up there.
Quite a bit of wave to play with here. They're waiting on that one. 1 minute and 40 seconds on to Dragon. Really be the only thing LMQ would say. This is too much of a stalemate. We're getting nothing. Let's go get Dragon. So far, a good hold on Baron by Team Solo mid. Only a bit of time left, maybe under a minute now left on Baron for LMQ to work this. Good shot, LMQ gets caught. There's the tidal wave as they ride it. Huge damage coming in. Gleam has forced to flash Dyrus as well, and LMQ can trade back.
Yeah, see, even with that pick, TSM cannot chase. Even if you take somebody out with no answer, there's no way that you can chase down.
That's a 14,000 gold behind fight.
Plus, the Baron buff was still on LMQ, so it's a really strong defense for TSM, though. And that's one step in many that they will have to take, but it's one step in the right direction for them. On the road to a comeback here for TSM. It's going to be a very long and arduous journey, though.
With that spike coming in from Wild Turtle, about 600 gold. If he can lock it down, what's he packing right now? He has it, so he has the Infinity Edge. Looks like he'll go back and get that right now.
Yeah.
If they can protect him, there might be a chance coming in here, because you're still not looking at that much armor on the side of LMQ.
And you got to keep your eyes on Bjergsen here, too. Xerath is a very good substitute for Ziggs in these situations, trying to defend. Mm-hmm. Also has extremely strong wave clear that can be used as harass at the same time. if you can aim true. That shot didn't mean anything, though. He didn't even need to hit that.
He was calibrating.
Little minions, he still got them. Exactly.
28-28 on the clock. That means LMQ is going to be getting himself a bit of Dragon Gold here. Dragon quite leveled up throughout the game. Almost there to that full average, or full average, but full gold you would be able to experience to get out of him. Dyrus. I'll just say he's playing a little dangerous here without any wards, but he should be able to stay safe with his whimsy speed.
I mean, TSM need to scavenge any gold they can find on the map here.
He's probably excited to find that.
LMQ just have these giant money bags. Their war chest is huge right now, and they're bringing all of it to TSM's front door. Looks like the Ackerman split push will be answered by two members of TSM. That seems like a A risky play there. See if LMQ can get some more damage down here on bottom. Three members of TSM heading up top. Four members! That's a large commitment. But LMQ not shoving heavily.
I'm interested to see if LMQ starts working a few of their teleports. Obviously, it's not going to be Xiaowei Xiao in the bottom lane for this Baron. Maybe it will, but it's going to be hard to get all the way up there. He's got to make a quick jaunt before he does it.
They want to at least secure everything on the map so that if LMQ make another mistake and TSM get a couple kills, then at least there won't be anything on the map for TSM to take in retaliation. So LMQ just biding their time, keeping up the pressure until Baron spawns, at which point they can just start up the Baron. And if TSM come, then that's great for them too, because they can bait him in through all the vision that they will have around Baron. But if TSM don't come, then they also just get the buff and then we'll turn towards the turrets once again.
I'm interested to see if some kind of crazy teleport comes out of Dyrus. He's got captain boots. So if he gets somewhere in place for the team to keep catching up, very interesting buy from him on the Lucidity captain.
Yeah. Right now, since Dyrus is always on the back line, the captain boots are mainly for retreating.
Right.
For
no, yeah.
Anybody on TSM who gets too far ahead.
Follow me.
Let's see what happens here. TF ulti does spot them coming in, and TSM do not make the call to go rush in, which would be definitely detrimental to their health. See if they can hold on here. This last outer turret should probably be given up by TSM. That is a very dangerous turret to defend, and nobody's in position. Dyrus, though, has to be real careful. Dyrus is trying to get that last outer from LMQ down before returning. That could cost them inhibitor.
He's got a lot of damage to do on that turret.
Okay, he's got his teleport. He's actually teleporting, not recalling. He might get there in time.
Yeah, she teleports back to the mid lane inhibitor turret. Still goes down. You're right, Kobe. And we're going to see the inhibitor now taking too much damage to be stomped. LMQ is not even pushed off. That's the Ackerman ultimate coming out. They still hold theirs, however, on the side of Team Solo mid. Nothing too big was used. Just the teleport in.
You cannot mess around with your inhibitor turrets. We've seen this so many times, especially in the North American LCS. Teams trying to answer some sort of little split push to grab a tiny bit of gold for their team, that outer turret of LMQ will not be the difference in the game. But holding onto every inhibitor turret is basically the only hope of these teams that are so far behind. Once that inhibitor turret line gets cracked, it's so easy for the team that's up over 15k gold to just rush right in. All right, it was 18k gold even. LMQ are up right now.
And history is really repeating itself in this game, Kobe. Previously, as we've seen in these games, it was 43 minutes and 54 minutes.
Yeah, they got the turret. They lost out the local gold, though, so it's only half.
Always trying
to. A little bit more than that.
But as soon as LMQ was able to get those inhibitors, it was less than a minute, then the game ended. So as soon as they break that open, it's very quick to the end. We'll see if they can do that once again here versus Team Solo Mid, a team that has not been able to get the number of LMQ. It's been very much the other way around in every game.
Yeah, massive mid-game LMQ here, looking like the number one team in North America right now.
Oh my gosh, they're not even past the turret and they can still just shoot out damage.
Too deep again.
Turret goes down, they may still have control over this fight though, as chaotic as it looks. Still sending TSM into a frenzy. Two are down. No Name is the only one that has fallen right now, and they still have the crowd control to continue the fight. Xiaowei Xiao gets shot back a bit, but they are going to be able to return to another inhibitor. Looks like they want the bottom now. They're going for everything. Actually, that was just going to be amazing going down. LMQ, very textbook play all throughout the match. If they needed the Baron, they took the Baron. If they needed a Dragon, it was theirs as well. And when they wanted it, they got the Nexus. 33 minutes in, LMQ takes down Team Solo Mid.
Great game by LMQ. They were able to take that one mistake from TSM, where TSM used up their global teleport. Dyrus teleport going up to the top lane or to the red buff, and TSM not getting anything out of it, pretty much snowballed the entire game against them. LMQ were able to make use of their mid-game power spike very effectively and steamroll their way to victory.
GG's, handshakes, and camaraderie from both teams. Very well played coming out of LMQ. We saw the Xerath from Bjergsen as he tried to bring something new into the NA scene. Did not work out with the control that was actually given in the mid lane by Xiaowei Xiao himself. At first, No Name was focusing on bottom, so Xiaowei Xiao fended off gank after gank, blowing Ghost and Flash, and then coming out on top of that lane. Bjergsen was one of the players we were to OP5 to watch this weekend. Had a little bit of a struggle there in the game.
But yeah,
Team Solo Mid definitely didn't play up to par there as a whole, though.
You definitely do have to give the props to that guy right there, Xiaowei Xiao, for playing that TF versus Xerath Rengar. As soon as he burned both of his summoner spells, had to play extremely passive, never got killed by the Rengar ultimate gank, and he still was able to get his TF roam down bottom and get that guy Vasili ahead, which was really where LMQ got a lot of that early game power. Getting Vasili buffed up in that lane and pretty much using that to start off pretty much all of LMQ's plays.
LMQ really